Hello everyone, I am Abaloyli Dignadise from BEd 1A and I am the first reporter in Module 3, Lesson 7. In previous chapter, they discussed and we learned about the origins of Philippine popular culture. We've discussed what popular culture means in the Philippines. So now we are going to move forward from the colonial times and focus on what popular in more recent years. So get ready to learn about the trend and what Filipinos enjoy today. So, before we proceed our discussion, I will read the learning outcomes first. So, at the end of this lesson, we portray how media becomes an important platform for the Philippine pop culture, synthesize the uniqueness of Philippine popular culture. So now we are going to discuss our topic, which is media and Philippine popular culture. When we say media, these are ways na makakuha tao ka ng entertainment and of course, information. Then this includes TV, newspapers, radio, and of course, sa Facebook, social media. Dahil yun na makakuha ang mga information. Then, ang Philippine popular culture is, this is what most Filipinos like and enjoy. So, this includes music, TV shows, movies, mga games, festivals, and of course, foods. Then, kung ato ni pagsamahon ang media and ang Philippine popular culture, this is media shows what's popular in Filipino culture. For example, ani katong pageant, di ba? Kita as Filipino, hilig mo yung itag pageant, no? So, from small barangay fiestas to grand city festivals, beauty pageants are frequently the highlights. So, di ba sa mga fiesta-fiesta yun, gikan sa mga small barangay, hangtod sa mga na mga festivals, ang pinaka-highlight yun, ana, is ang beauty pageant. And, naka-remember mo atong Miss Universe pageant ni Miss Maxine Medina, 2016 to siya nga Miss Universe. Then, nakita ba ito is, she had quite the pressure during the competition when avid Filipino pageant enthusiast criticized her for having poor English communication skills. The collective criticism that Medina received online forced her to make a move that was not initially on her plan. She only hired an interpreter after following. So, katong nga time ang katong sa Miss Universe is na-pressure jud si Medina ato kay tungod sa iyang mga nadawat bitaw nga mga criticism gikan sa mga netizens ato kay kanang tungod sa iyang tungod pala ay sugod pa lang atong sa conference niya is dito man gud nakitaan sa iyahan na mga na kuan sa iyang mga netizens nga hina siya o kanang English communication skills. So katong tungod ato nga criticism nga ihang nadawat, napugos siya og kuha og interpreter nga maputo nga time nga murag ni ang mga netizens bitaw ato is nag suggest sila kay Medina nga mukuha na lang og interpreter, which is nga wala sa iyang plano unta nag-hire siya og interpreter ato nga time sa ihang Miss Universe pageant. Then now if we actually acknowledge the nuance that Medina could have fared better during the pageant if it weren't for the inaccurate translations, then should we assume that she could have won the pageant if she had not listened to the negative sentiments and never hired the interpreter? So, lisod yung kayo na ito matag na ano, lisod, ganang dili yung ito makaingon nung makadaog siya ato or mapildi siya kay, siguro ang mga netizen yung ito is kanang ginabantayan na yung siya ato kay sa conference pa lang din, hina yung siya og English. So, katupong sa interpreter nila, murag niya is, ang mga netizens po dito, murag nakulangan bitaw sila sa pag-interpret at ang interpreter nga nakuha ni Medina. Kay siguro ba si ang mga tao ato, kung tungod ba atong, kung nikuha, kung wala ba siya nikuha atong interpreter, is makadaog ba siya? So, lisod po kayo na ito, makuha na nung, pero at least, gihatag yun niya yahang best atong, kung at least, di ba, naka-top 6 siya ato din. Mo to ang, naka-top 6 man siya ato, at least gihatag niya kaysa naman wala yun siya nakapil ato, at least kanang murag nanon po ng Philippines ba, at least nga ang mga Pinoy yun is makapasok yun siya sa mga Miss Universe yun, mga top like atong kang Medina naka-top 6 siya, so happy na po ta ato nga as Pinoy no nga nakasulod siya top 6. So dihan na to makuanan nga ang nga ang media and ang Philippine popular cultures are like a mirror reflecting what Filipinos think, feel and enjoy. So, kato lang. Thank you.
Good day, everyone. This is Jen Ford Ibanez Coquilla. And before I break down the role of social media and Philippine popular culture, let us first discuss a perspective that will aid in our later exploration of the said topic. So now we have the agenda setting theory. So it is a perspective introduced by Maxwell Mankobs and Donald Shaw. Simply put, the theory proposes that the media influences people to focus its attention on something under a certain agenda. So, it means nga, ang media daw, maka-influence siya sa mga tao to think na there is something bigger or there is something more important na nahitabo even though ug wala. Okay? So, ang common example ani is kaning mga text formatting sa newspaper. So, di ba ang kanang mga kasagaran nga, mga supposed na mga important news, kay kasagaran makita siya sa front page sa newspaper. So, there are mga huge headlines, naka-bold, mga dagko kay na fans, nga na. And then, ang mga other news nga considered siya as unimportant, na makita na siya sa sunod na mga page, pero gagmay na yung fans. So, unlike sa katong nasa front page, di na siya dagko. So now, how is this theory relevant to the role of media in Philippine popular culture? According to Lumbera, kung nakarecall pa mo itong sa previous chapter na to, so ana siya nga ang popular culture and the rise of technology like the television and the radio soon deteriorated the notion of art and made it appear that it is consumable and commodity. So, ang iyang giminan nga niya nga statement is that ang quality daw sa art karon is nagkagamay, nagka-less ang quality. So, in order na makater ang kada mga customer's taste, and ang mga contents karon ng ginaproduce is for the sake na lang of what sells. Diba? So, bali nawala na ang kanang self-expression sa kanong sa naghimo kay ang iyang gibuhat naman is nagadepende na sa kung unsa ang gusto sa tao, dili na sa kung unsa iyang gusto na himuon. So, moto siya. And then, take the rise of infotainment as an example. So, a Yahoo Nielsen survey from 2013 concluded that infotainment content are what was most sought out in the Philippines. In an essay, Gargi Torima explained that this meant a lot of irrelevant news we see on the television or internet that can be dismissed as a fad but were given the limelight to amuse people and people seem to buy it. So, ato siyang tanawon in another way. So, kanang it means nga kanang ang mga tao daw is ginakonsume nila ang news not because of the entire information but because of the entertainment na nahatag niya. So, let's say, for example, kaning akong ipakita sa inyo na photo. Okay, so, kaning siya na photo, it was taken from a Facebook page called Explained that is tagged as a news and media website. So kaning a photo, it is a news article detailing Health Secretary Duque's clarification of his remark on the status of the Philippines amidst the pandemic. Okay, so, although ang kanina article is nag-contain siya og clear coverage of the news, pero the headline itself, nakakuha og kanang, mas nakakuha og more attention, na nakakuha dire is thousands of people, nakakuha siya og kanang attention from a thousand of people for its parody of the song Just Give Me a Reason by Pink, earning more than 14,000 shares as of writing. So, diba, while it sparked an intellectual discussion in the comment section, it also ignited a plethora of jokes and amused remarks, shying away from the important information and highlighting the comedy behind the headline. So, kung ato ang basahon ng headline niya, so, may siyang headline, "We're not flattened, just bent. Secretary Duque pulls off flattened remark, giving us reasons." So, kana siyang title, diraan na nag-focus ang mga tao. Dili na siya sa information nga nasulod ang nga article. So, bale, nawala na nga to ang focus dito sa information nga dapat na to tagaan og atensyon kay diraan na naad to. Okay, so mo nang muto siyang pasabot sa iyang sa giingon ni kuan ni Garkitorima. Sige, explain niya nga, this meant a lot of irrelevant news we see on the television or internet that can be dismissed as a fad, but we're given the limelight to amuse people and people seem to buy it. So, nag-focus na sila sa joke, so nag-focus na sila sa entertainment. Wala na sila nag-focus ito sa information na dapat na ito na tagaan o pansin. Okay? So, muna siya. So, that is all for my report. And then, the next reporter will be Miss Marisa.
Good day, ma'am. Good day, everyone. I am Marisol L. Dulip. So, let us go back to the federal sentiment regarding the deterioration of an art into the commodity aspect of popular culture and the media cross-promotion, which can be defined as the promotion of an advertisement in a very subtle way inside another program or the like. So, cross-promotions happen a lot in a Philippine films. The example ano is ang Moving at the House of Us. So, sa pelikula no is gitry sa karakter ni Daniel Padilla or Primo na ibaligi kay Catherine Bernardo or George ang iyang sabon o lipstick. So kini siya is ginatawag ni siya o product replacement o ang pagbutang o mga produkto sa mga sine or shows sa television isip usa ka pamaagi sa pag-promote sa usa ka product. So, if we look at it, the media can influence the Philippine popular culture in a many discrete ways that sometimes we fail to notice. So, second example ani is ang mga television network is ang mga television network sa Pilipinas is nagapagawas na sila og mga Mexican telenovela sa tanan nga mga melodramatic na mga storyline. So example ani no ang teleserye nga Ruby, Marimar ug Rosalinda. So nga gihimuan nila og Filipino remake. So naay mga panahon aton, naay mga panahon no nga kuan is ang mga bata is nagabutang sila og bulak sa ilahang kilid silang dulungan para gayahon daw si Rosalinda. And also the Taiwanese or Korean drama nga ginatawag nato og Asian novela. So nagabukas nino para kita mga Pilipino is dawaton nato ang ilahang kultura. Lalo na sa ilahang mga music, product, pagkaon and also sa ilahang wika. So, ang internet o ang social media is nagabigay daan ni siya para ang Asian o ang Western series is dali ra nato magustuhan like sa mga streaming sites sa Netflix di mo matan-aw na nato ni sila. So nagahatag pud di og access sa ato ano para ma-appreciate nato ang lahi-lahi nga mga kultura diri asa
Good day everyone, my name is Jimmy Croma and I'm a reporter of Group 7. Have you heard or tested about Korean dish? Or are you familiar with samgyeopsal and the famous Korean fire noodles which associate the fire noodles challenge? Will those things become popular because of online sharing and, in short, through the use of internet or media? The agenda setting theory is theory that suggests that media can persuade, convince, and influence people to look at things as if it were the only things that matters, like the most important things in the world. You see, people nowadays love to associate themselves with different issue because it's trending even it was nothing to do with them. The same scenario applied to in Mediana. Many people criticize Mediana is a grammatical error but issue blew up not because of her grammar but because of bandwagon people voluntarily joined the hate train because it was trending, famous, and popular. The irrelevant shares and negative comments online stress which critique the unfamiliar process of the interpreter and others factors may have contributed to her not being able to give a satisfactory answer. Conclusion: media and scenario clearly show the praise because although social media can't be used to power its user, it can also be a tool to destroy someone. Long building self-esteem depending on how the user use the platform. Different theory tell that media goals is grow of popular culture while crafting a developed world. Borrowing apart from Lombardia, quotes, popular culture is a power. Historically, our ancestors were able to win popular culture as a weapon to push for a better society. And we could do the same things through the proper use of social media, along with an easy access to proper popular cultures to create and educate, we can make a progress. Thank you.